We're given f of x and g of x and asked to determine the following composition of functions. The idea of a composition of functions is that the output of the inner function becomes the input of the outer function, giving us a final output for the composition of functions. To help visualize this, we can think of this as a conveyor belt, where if we start with an input for the inner function, this gives us an output. This output becomes the input for the outer function, which gives us a final output for the composition of functions. So looking at our first example, there are two main ways to express a composition of functions as we see here. These two are equivalent, and we say f of g of 7 in both cases. But when evaluating a composition of functions, this notation here is usually more helpful. We're going to start with the innermost function and evaluate g of 7. So to evaluate g of 7, we'll substitute 7 for x in function g, which is here. So we'd have 6 times 7 squared minus 4 times 7 plus 5. Well, 7 squared is 49. 49 times 6 is equal to 294. So we have 294 minus 28 plus 5, which is equal to 271. And now, since g of 7 equals 271, f of g of 7 is equal to f of 271. So notice how the output of g of 7 becomes the input into function f. So that would give us 2 times 271 minus 3, which would be 542 minus 3, or 539. So f of g of 7 equals 539. Next we have g of f of 2. We'll begin by determining f of 2, the inner function value. So f of 2 would be equal to 2 times 2 minus 3. Well, that's just 4 minus 3, or 1. And again, since f of 2 is equal to 1, we can rewrite g of f of 2 as g of 1. So now we'll substitute 1 into function g to find the final output of this composition of functions. We'd have 6 times 1 squared minus 4 times 1 plus 5. Well, that would be 6 minus 4, that's 2. 2 plus 5 is 7. So g of f of 2 equals 7. Notice how it is important that we pay close attention to the order of the composition. Next we have f of g of negative 3. So we'll begin by determining the value of the inner function, g of negative 3, which would be 6 times negative 3 squared minus 4 times negative 3 plus 5. Well, negative 3 squared is 9. 9 times 6 is 54. This would be plus 12. Plus 5, so this is 71. Since g of negative 3 equals 71, we can rewrite f of g of negative 3 as f of 71. So 71 becomes the input into function f, which is 2 times 71 minus 3, which is 142 minus 3, or 139. So f of g of negative 3 equals 139. And for our last example, notice how we have f of negative 4. We begin by determining the inner function value f of negative 4, which would be 2 times negative 4 minus 3. That's negative 8 minus 3, or negative 11. And since the inner function value f of negative 4 equals negative 11, f of negative 4 is equal to f of negative 11. So negative 11 is now the input into function f, which would be 2 times negative 11 minus 3. That'd be negative 22 minus 3, that's negative 25. So f of negative 4 equals negative 25. I hope you found this helpful.